God, you gotta love it. Hey, and we still have probably a couple thousand more people that are still lined up outside trying to get in here. So that's just awesome. It is just awesome. So thank you so much, Detroit. You are an amazing, amazing city. Thank you, Michigan. And I'm going to say this again. My role up here today is to introduce America's mayor, Mayor Giuliani, who's going to come out here. And he's awesome. He is awesome. You guys are great. Thank you. Okay, this election, this represents a change election. Our country will go in one direction or the other, and what we want is we want to take America back. I mean, we want America to be exactly what we know it to be. We want it to represent that flag. We want it to represent all of the American people around this country, every single one of them, including all the deplorables. I am one. I'm proud to wear that name. There are so many risks that we face. And you're going to hear all this tonight. Donald Trump will come out here and he'll talk about, you know, illegal immigration and protecting our border and protecting our country. One of the things, and I would love to have a real shout out to all of our veterans, all veterans in the room. Woo! Hoo-ah! That's right. The men and women who serve in our armed forces, they deserve so much. And their families deserve so much. And our military, I will tell you, I'm standing up here tonight, and I'm standing alongside Donald Trump to be the next president of the United States, because when I look at our military has been depleted. We have the smallest army since World War II. We have the smallest Navy. The smallest Navy since World War I. We have the smallest Air Force we've ever had. And God love our Marine Corps. Any Marines in here tonight? Hurrah, hurrah, Marine, hurrah. Yeah, Marines say hurrah, hurrah, Marines. I hear ya. Another critical issue, very, very critical issue. The Supreme Court of the United States of America. And we must. I mean, this is such an important issue with this, and many people don't understand it. Most Americans, they think about it and you don't really understand it, but trust me, the Supreme Court of the United States of America, it basically sets our way of life. It protects the rule of law in our country. And we have to make sure that we put the right person in the White House, because the likelihood of somewhere between three, maybe five Supreme Court justices could be changed, and that is an unbelievable. Imagine Hillary Clinton putting Supreme Court. No, boo, boo. This election is about leadership. It's about honesty versus the status quo and someone who just doesn't know how to tell the truth. Hillary Clinton is so corrupt. She's just everything that comes out of her mouth, you just wonder, I mean, why does she even talk anymore? The amount of lies that she continues to say. Another group that I want to address in here tonight, and you see them here. You got the Secret Service. You look all around, and I'm sure as you drove into the parking lot tonight, is all of those men and women who serve in blue, who wear, you know, Blue Lives Matter. Our law enforcement, our cops. God love them. I mean, our police in this country are under assault. The rule of law in this country is under assault. If there's one thing that we have to protect the rule of law in this country. And the first line of defense for protecting our rule of law is the men and women who serve us on a law enforcement professionals on a daily basis. And let's give them another big round of applause. Now, one of the things that I like to do when we travel around is that we travel around together, and that's to introduce America's mayor, Rudy Giuliani. I will tell you, that's right. Now, this is a tough guy. New York City mayor. I mean, when he was the mayor of New York, he brought crime down so much, unbelievable, and you'll hear more about that tonight. But the best city in the world, New York City, under Mayor Giuliani, unbelievable guy, America's mayor. Let me introduce the next speaker, America's mayor, Mayor Rudy Giuliani.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, it's very, very nice to be here in Michigan and in a place that I know we're going to win in November. I got to tell you, you really have Hillary Clinton and the Democrats very, very nervous. They're basically pulling out of Ohio. I predict in 2 weeks we'll get them to pull out of here. You see this little group in front of me right here? No, just this little group, just in numbers. That's about what she draws at her crowd. And this is a Trump rally. You think she can beat that enthusiasm? You know why you're enthusiastic? Well, let's take the positive part first. You have
a... I'm Jamie Foxx for Verizon. In the nation's largest independent study,
give me 1 second. For some reason, I don't know what the hell happened. I'm still trying to figure out. I think it got cut from any other ones, but hold on, let's see.
Failed economics 101. Because
Because if you think you're going to create more jobs by raising taxes on businesses, you do not understand economics. You're ignorant and you're out of your mind. And you have no understanding of economics. Here's how you create new jobs. You take a 35% tax rate, which is the highest in the world, and driving companies to places where the tax rates are lower, like Pfizer, the big plant in Ireland, where the tax rate is 12.5%,
by charging them,
you lower the tax rate to 35%, about 10%. And all that money comes back into the United States. And you know what it's used for? It's used for jobs, and more jobs, and better jobs, and more opportunities. Then,
USA,
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 not only,
USA,
not only did she misrepresent about that, but when she was talking on Monday night, she said that Donald Trump wants to lower taxes the most on the rich. Wrong. Except, unlike Donald Trump, Lester Holt never interrupted her when she was wrong. He didn't say no. Simple arithmetic goes to the lowest tax rate. It's going to go down from 38% to 33%, from 33% to 25%, and from 25% to 15%. The biggest reduction will be for the middle class. Once again, Hillary was wrong. But you didn't see Lester Holt come in and say, Hillary, you're wrong. I just did the arithmetic. The other way you create jobs is you negotiate sensible tax deals. Donald Trump will renegotiate NAFTA. Do you know how many jobs you lost here in Michigan because of NAFTA? Do you know how many people are out of work or who have jobs that are below what they should be making? Thousands and thousands and thousands. Do you know who passed NAFTA? Bill Clinton. Do you know who supported it? Hillary Clinton. And once again during the debate, she didn't tell the truth. She said, well, she never really said that the TPP, which is the trade agreement with the Pacific, which hasn't been passed yet, which will be almost as bad as NAFTA and take as many jobs from us as NAFTA. She said, she never said it was the gold standard. She said it could be. 3 minutes after the debate was over, there she was on television saying, the TPP is the gold standard. Once again, she didn't tell the truth. Once again, she lied. And once again, nobody interrupted her and said, you're wrong. And every single time Donald Trump was interrupted, it turned out that Lester Holt and Hillary Clinton were wrong. They said, both of them said, that stop and frisk has been found unconstitutional. I have news for you. Stop and frisk is alive and well. It was decided by the Supreme Court in 1968, Terry versus Ohio. It is still the law of the land. It doesn't matter what Lester Holt thinks. It doesn't matter what Hillary Clinton thinks, because just like she failed economics 101, she failed her bar exam. I mean it, she did. Their ignorance of the law is only exceeded by their ignorance of foreign policy, where every single thing that she touched in this world turned out much worse. She was given a world far safer, far better, and an America that was far safer than the America of today, where we are waiting for the next attack, and we have a president who takes 3 days to react to it, and we have a president and a former Secretary of State who cannot say radical Islamic terrorism is at war against us. Well, you have a chance to elect a man who can stand up to radical Islamic terrorism, to to a man who can create jobs for you to deserve. A man who can bring the ladder of success right into the heart of Detroit and pull people out of poverty. The right way, with safety, a good job, and a good education. And that man is Donald Trump. And you will be hearing from him in a few moments. Make sure you vote. God bless you. God bless Michigan, and God bless the United States of America.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. It is so great to be back in Michigan, a state I've come to know and love during this campaign. You know, we won Michigan, and that was a great, big, fat, beautiful victory. You know that, right? And I've been talking about Michigan for a long time. We can't let them take your car industry out or your industry out of your state any longer. Not gonna happen. I'm going to fight so hard for all of you, and I'm going to bring back the jobs that have been stripped away from you and from our country. In 39 days, 39 days, can you imagine? This started off, we were a long ways away, and some people didn't give us a good chance. They said, Mr. Trump, the other day, one of the biggest people in that business, the very dishonest press business, they said, Mr. Trump, when you started off, you have to tell me the truth. Did you really think you'd be here? I said, what the hell do you think I'm doing this for? Right? No, we expected to be here, and we're all here together. It's a movement, and believe me, we're all here together. We're going to take our country back. We're going to win the state of Michigan. We're going to win the White House, and it's going to be an awfully good November 8th. That evening is going to be a celebration. We're going to take on the special interests, the lobbyists, and the powerful politicians that have stolen your jobs, through theft and incompetence. They've stolen your wealth. They've taken your middle class. We're going to take on the arrogant, corrupt corporate media that have enabled the global theft of American prosperity. A theft that has left behind crumbling schools, roads, bridges, and a totally depleted military. We have the greatest people in the world in our military. We're going to rebuild our military. This is when we need it. It's time, by the way, to rebuild Detroit. We're going to rebuild Detroit. It's time to rebuild Michigan, and we're not letting them take your jobs out of Michigan any longer. And it's time to rebuild the United States of America. We're going to do it. Our country is going to be greater than ever before. We're going to be the smart country again. Hillary Clinton has made a living raking in donations from special interests that have raided our factories and ripped the jobs right out of Michigan and every other state. That's how she gets rich. By taking your jobs and your money away from you and away from your state. That's why Hillary Clinton, if she ever got the chance, would 100% approve the Trans-Pacific Partnership. The deal she lied about the other night, when I said she called it the gold standard, she said no. Guess what? She called it the gold standard. And Lester Holt didn't correct her. I wonder why. The Trans-Pacific Partnership will economically devastate Michigan, New Hampshire, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, and so many other states all across this country. It will be devastating also for Ohio. Hillary Clinton's donors want the TPP, and their wish will be her command. That's what it is. These special interests pay her for speeches. And she's not a good speaker. Not a good speaker. They pay her a lot of money. You know, we have thousands of people here today. There are thousands and thousands of people outside trying to get in. Thousands. And they're coming in. And in fact, I was going to ask you, should we hold it up for a couple of hours, let everyone pour in? You know, they're all checked. The answer is no, right? Thank you. Now they'll get it. They pay her foundation. They pay her husband. In return, they get your jobs. Like I've been saying all week, when it comes to Hillary Clinton, all you have to do is remember these words. Follow the money. Let's go. That's become very popular, I will say. Hillary Clinton praised or pushed TPP on 45 separate occasions. Her close associate and confidant, Governor Terry McAuliffe, said she'd pass it, don't worry. Her husband talks it up. Everyone knows she's for it because she doesn't believe in protecting American jobs or American sovereignty. She doesn't believe it. Hillary Clinton only believes in protecting her special interests and her donors. Of the 262 companies that lobbied for the passage of TPP, 82, or nearly 1 in 3, donated between $21 and $67 $1 million to the Clinton Foundation. Think of that. Nine companies that lobbied for the passage of TPP paid Hillary Clinton $2.7 million for paid speeches. Who would want to hear Hillary Clinton speak and pay her $200, $300, $400, $500,000? Who? You think so? You know, so we're going to have 20,000 people here, easy, including outside much more than that. If she came here tomorrow, if she got 500 people, seriously, I think it would be a shock, right? It would be a shock. Three TPP member countries gave between $6 and $15 million. Think of that. At least four lobbies who are actively lobbying for TPP passage have raised more than $800,000 for her campaign. On November 8th, we are going to end Clinton corruption. We've had enough. And we're going to do something that has been a long, long time in coming. We are going to put America first. We are going to put America first. Hillary Clinton is an insider fighting only for herself and for her donors. I'm an outsider fighting for you. We have a movement like they've never seen in this country before. The corrupt media, which is totally corrupt, these people back there, totally corrupt, working along with the political establishment and the establishment, is panicking because they know this is awfully tough to stop what's happening right now, folks. Awfully tough. The news anchors and the donors and the lobbyists who are used to getting their way are trying to do everything they can to help crooked Hillary Clinton and to cling to their power and their prestige and their money. The arrogant political class doesn't believe in protecting jobs and wages for Americans. Do you know, we have many people in the audience and all over the country that made more money in real wages 18 and 20 years ago than they're making now. And now, because of Obamacare and other reasons, they're being forced to work two jobs, sometimes three jobs. So they're getting older, they're working harder, and they're being paid less. Not good. The only thing I can say is that I'm getting older and I'm working harder also, okay? So I'm putting myself in your category. It's true. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, oh, that's so true, though, isn't it? The special interests don't believe in secure borders and strong walls. The Washington and Wall Street insiders don't believe in hiring more police, producing more American energy, or giving school choice to poor children trapped in failing schools. And we are, by the way, going to end Common Core and bring education local. For decades, we've talked about the corruption and incompetence and failures of our leaders. In 2016, it's a long-awaited chance to deliver the change that you've been waiting for a long time and to hold our politicians accountable. If you do this one simple thing, you can deliver justice for every single person who has been wronged by the system. On November 8th, show up and vote. Show up and vote, folks. Show up and vote. If you are so sick, if you get the worst report you could possibly get for the doctor, if the doctor says, I'm sorry, Jim, I'm sorry, Alice, I'm sorry, whoever it is, you're not going to make it. You're not going to make it. You'll be gone by the end of November. I don't give a damn. Show up and vote on November 8th. No, we don't want that to happen. We don't want that to happen. When you cast that ballot, just picture a Wall Street boardroom filled with the special interests who have been bleeding your country and your city and every place else. And imagine the look on their faces when you tell them you're fired. Fired. And we're going to tell millions and millions of unemployed Americans my favorite two words. You're hired. When we get it going, folks, millions of jobs are going to come pouring back into our country. We're going to reverse the trend. Right now, we have a superhighway. It goes in one direction, out of our country. Our jobs are gone. Our money's gone. Our wealth is gone. We owe $20 trillion. Obama has doubled the debt, doubled it in his term in office. $20 trillion. And we haven't done anything. Our roads are bad. Our schools are bad. Our airports are bad. Our hospitals are bad. Our bridges, our tunnels. They're all falling apart. You know, it's one thing if we would have spent the money and fixed our country. We've spent $6 trillion in the Middle East. We could have rebuilt our country twice. Now the media doesn't want to talk about Hillary Clinton and her corruption. So we're going to spell it out for them today. The large corporations who support terrible trade deals that ship your jobs overseas and out of our country, they're donating to Hillary Clinton. Follow the money. The Wall Street investors who have rigged the regulations against the middle class, they're donating to Hillary Clinton. Follow the money. The wealthy donors who want to shut down American energy, they're donating to Hillary Clinton. Follow the money. The special interests who want open borders are donating to Hillary Clinton. Definitely follow the money. In her campaign for president, Hillary Clinton has received $100 million in contributions from Wall Street and hedge funds. And by the way, I'm spending a lot of money on my campaign. And why isn't she spending some money on hers? I'm spending $100 million. You know what I'm spending? I think I'll be over $100 million. But you know what's nice? When they call me and they say, Mr. President, you have to do this, you have to do that. I say, I don't have to do anything for anybody. The only one that I'm working for is you. That's the only one. You watch. So many things are done adverse to the country. And I've spent a tremendous tens and tens of millions of dollars on the primaries and now on the general election. And I'm very proud to have done it, I will tell you. And I don't know to this extent if it's ever done, been done before. Certainly not recently. But I'm very proud to have done it because we're going to maintain our independence. We have millions and millions of dollars coming in from small donors, average like $61 a shot. And that's really helping to fund the campaign also. But these are people who are investing in our country. These are great, great people. They're investing in our country. So Hillary and Bill were paid $150 million for speeches since Bill Clinton left the Oval Office, $150. Did they get their money's worth? Well, maybe they did, not from the speech. The same groups are paying Bill and Hillary for their speeches. These were the groups that were lobbying, in many cases, the federal government. I'm shocked. 22 groups paying Bill Clinton for speeches lobbied the State Department while Hillary was Secretary of State. Shocking. Favors and access were granted to those who wrote checks. She put the office of Secretary of State up for sale, and she never ever got the chance, and she will get the chance if we don't get out to vote. She will get the chance, and we can't let that happen. Because if she gets the chance, she will put the Oval Office up for sale like she always does. Remember, folks, she's been doing this for 30 years and she just doesn't produce. She deleted and bleached 33,000 emails after a congressional subpoena. You can't do that. The subpoena. How about this? You get a federal subpoena. You get a subpoena from Congress. I mean, how high can it get? To give your emails, to give your papers, to give everything. It isn't before you get the subpoena. This is after you get the subpoena. And after you get the subpoena, you delete and bleach. A process nobody ever heard of. Who heard of that in this room? Did anybody ever hear of it? They call it bleaching. They call it acid washing. And a lot of people don't do it because it's supposed to be very expensive. But nobody heard of it. So she gets a subpoena. She doesn't like it. She says, in my opinion, or somebody does, but she says, delete all of my emails. Delete them. And then she said, and by the way, is there another process where they can never find them? Yes, ma'am, we can bleach them. Then bleach them. Because I don't want anybody to see the wedding and the yoga classes, right? She said they were wedding and yoga class tweets. I give five for the wedding and three for the yoga class, but what about the rest? In addition, she got rid of 13 phones. They were missing or gone, and several were destroyed by a hammer. Who ever destroyed your phone with a hammer? Is there anybody? There's one person. What business are you in? Foreign enemies with easy access to hack, and believe me, she's vulnerable, and she makes us vulnerable because foreign enemies, you look at her server, and they're probably hacking her all over the place. Unfortunately, maybe we'll find out at a later date. Lies to Congress under oath. She lies to Congress. How many times did she lie to Congress? And then the media protects her, and they don't talk about that. And if I'm a little bit off, Trump lies, lies. She lied to Congress so many times. And how about her people and representatives taking the Fifth Amendment and her ringleaders getting immunity deals, five immunity deals. We call them now the FBI Immunity Five. So, listen to this. Listen to this. Here's my question for Hillary Clinton. Can you promise that not one of the five people who were granted criminal immunity will ever be allowed to serve in a Clinton administration if that ever happens? Oh, would that be bad? Let's see what happens. And here's a demand I'm making today to President Obama. Mr. President, will you pledge not to issue a pardon to Hillary Clinton and her co-conspirators for their many crimes against our country and against society itself? Will you make that pledge? No one is above the law. Clinton and her cronies will say anything, do anything, lie about anything to keep their grip on power, to keep their control over our country. Remember the Clinton pardon a fugitive, and this was a serious fugitive, Mark Rich, in exchange for unknown and undisclosed amounts of money. You remember that? Mark Rich. Famous Mark Rich. People couldn't believe it. The American people have had it with years or decades of Clinton corruption and scandals. Always the same thing. Whitewater, the cattle. Remember the cattle? I think she had the greatest return on a cattle investment in the history of the cattle world. Guys that did it all their lives, they said, wow, she must know a lot about cattle. The people of this country are tired of the lies. They're tired of trivial politics. They're tired of being talked down to, looked down upon, and treated like second-class citizens. This will finally be the year that the American people say, enough is enough. Hillary Clinton has been a disaster for so many communities, but especially for the African American communities. I don't think African Americans are going to come out and vote for Clinton. They're too smart, and they know they are being used. They're tired of it. They also know from tremendous past experience that she'll do nothing for them once the election is over. She never does, and that will never change. Many of them will not forget her calling young African-American men super predators. Super predators. To the African-American community, let me ask you this question. Are you better off than you were 8 years ago? No. If not, why not give Donald Trump a chance? I will fix it. I will bring back jobs. I'll bring back your education, which is a total disaster in the inner cities. And I'm going to bring back safe neighborhoods. If you keep voting for the same people, you will keep getting the exact same results. Look at what the Democrats have done to Detroit. Half of Detroit residents are unable to work. Nearly 40% of the city lives in poverty. It's the second most dangerous city in America, according to the FBI. This is the legacy of the policies embraced by crooked Hillary Clinton. A Trump administration will bring prosperity to all of our people. My economic agenda can be summed up with three very beautiful words. Jobs, jobs, jobs. We're bringing our jobs back. We're going to pass the biggest tax cut since Ronald Reagan. And by the way, Hillary Clinton is going to raise your taxes. Every wasteful and unnecessary regulation will be immediately eliminated. They're choking our businesses and stopping our jobs. We will unleash the power of American energy. The catastrophe known as Obamacare will be repealed and replaced. And the disastrous trade deals like NAFTA, signed by Bill Clinton, that have caused so much pain in Michigan and Ohio and Pennsylvania and everywhere in this country, will be renegotiated and will bring back your auto manufacturing business like you've never, ever seen it before. Michigan has lost more than one in three of its manufacturing jobs since the twin disasters of NAFTA and China's entrance into the WTO, another Bill Clinton disaster. Before NAFTA went into effect, there were 280,000 auto workers in Michigan. Today, that number is only 160,000, and believe me, it's going down and going down fast. And after the election, if somebody else should win, you're going to see really big reductions in those numbers. I can promise you that, because that's what they're going to do. And I've been talking about Michigan. I was honored here years ago, and we set the all-time record. Years ago, long before I ever thought I was going to be doing this, whoever thought I was going to run for office, I was going to be a politician. Can't believe somebody said, Donald, you're a politician. I said, please, I don't want to hear that. But whoever thought. But long before I thought about doing this, I was honored in Michigan. And I talked about your car industry is moving out. And had I run for office then and won, you would have double and triple the number of workers in your car industry, your automobile industry. I guarantee you that. But we'll get them back anyway. Ford just announced that it's moving its small car production to Mexico. So, it used to be that the cars were made in Flint and you couldn't drink the water in Mexico. Today, the cars are made in Mexico and you can't drink the water in Flint. That's what's happened to our country. Hillary Clinton also gave us the job-killing trade deal with South Korea, which has been a disaster. It's cost our country another 100,000 jobs. And Hillary opposed the Korea deal when she was running for president in 2007. She campaigned right here in Michigan and said, the Korea deal will hurt the United States auto industry, increase our trade deficit, cost us good middle-class jobs, and make America less competitive. She pledged to you to reject the deal, but she lied, as always. She lied. Once installed, as Secretary of State, she supported it and called it a cutting-edge transaction. Same thing's going to happen with TPP. Don't give her the chance, folks. You're going to lose all your jobs. Don't forget, when she ran for the Senate in New York State, she said she was going to bring back jobs in upstate New York. It was a total lie. We lost more and more jobs, and today it's a total disaster. She rammed it through, as she always tries to do. Her donors were happy. They were all extremely friendly to her. They helped her out. Everybody was satisfied, except for the workers of our country. We lost our jobs. The U.S. trade deficit with Korea for the top 10 products that Michigan exports to Korea grew 54% as exports fell and imports rose. So it was an exact opposite of what she said. And she probably knew it, although I personally think she's incompetent. She might not have known it. Don't forget, she has a distinction. She failed her bar exam in Washington, D.C. Remember that. That's a big distinction. This is what Hillary Clinton did for your state. According to the Economic Policy Institute, Michigan ranks first for jobs lost as a share of workforce due to the trade deficit with TPP members. Okay? Just imagine how many more jobs will be lost if the TPP actually gets approved, as Hillary Clinton wants to make sure it happens. Hillary Clinton is merely a vessel for the special interests trying to strip this country of its wealth, its jobs, and its status as a sovereign nation. She even supports the disastrous surrender of America's control of the internet, which is happening now. How about Obama? How about Obama wants to give the internet, let it be given to the world? What a bunch of people we have representing us. What a bunch of people. See how nice I'm doing, you know? A year ago, I would have said something vicious, and they would have said, Donald Trump uses foul language. What a group we have. How about where Obama, on the worst deal that I've ever seen negotiated, the Iran deal, started by Hillary Clinton, by the way, which will give them nuclear weapons in less than 10 years, and it's an easy path. But how about where he gave them $400 million in cash? And then it turned out to be wrong. It was $1.7 billion in cash. Can you believe? You know what that is? It's take that corner of the room and stack the cash to the ceiling. Nobody's seen that. Has anybody ever seen $1.7 billion in cash? What a bunch of losers we have. Hillary Clinton's website says she supports the decision to give away the internet to a global community of stakeholders. Isn't that nice? We come up with the internet and they want to give it away. Isn't that wonderful? Someone needs to inform Hillary Clinton it's not the job of our leaders to represent the global community. It's the job of our leaders to represent American citizens. We invent the internet. Let's just give it away, folks. Let's just give it away. Hard, it really is, honestly. Is it hard to believe or what? Forget about running for office. Forget about voting. Forget about politics. Can you believe the things they do? 400 million? Turns out to be 1.7. In cash, the internet. How about last week, where they were going to deport 800 people. Now, they have a reason they were going to deport them, right? So they were going to deport 800 people. And guess what? Something went wrong. And instead of deporting them, they became citizens of the United States of America. Only in America. Don King, who supported me, Big Don, he goes, only in America can that happen. But they were wrong. But there was a mistake. There was a mistake. It turned out that the 800 person number was wrong. It looks like it's now going to be close to 1,800. And then I said, okay, they made a big mistake. Let's turn it around and let's deport them. And they said, but that wouldn't be constitutional. Can you believe these people? Can you believe these people? America losing control of the internet to foreign entities is just one more way Obama, Clinton have sold out the citizens of this country. Somebody's benefiting by that deal, because nobody can be so stupid to make a deal like that. Somebody is benefiting by that deal. Hillary Clinton is a globalist who will never protect the freedom and jobs of the American people. I'm not running to be president of the world. I'm running to be president of the United States of America. Have you ever wondered why it is that all things that the American people want never, ever seem to happen? The reason's simple. It's because the financial interests who control our politics and our media, which is one of the most dishonest groups of people ever in this country. Like, for instance, look at this massive crowd. They don't show the crowd, folks. I go home, my wife said, oh, were there many people? I say, thousands. She goes, really? I didn't see them. They don't show them. Hey, cameras, why don't you span the room and show the room, cameras? Span the room. They won't do it. They won't do it. They never do it. They never do it. They're dishonest people. Dishonest people. I remember during the primaries, when Bernie Sanders was doing well, he made a terrible deal. He sold out to the devil, you know that. And now people don't even want to show up for Bernie. He sold out. He should have never made that deal. He should have gone down. He would have been an American hero. He sold out to Hillary Clinton. He sold out to the devil, and his people don't want anything to do with him. He had an event the other day. Almost nobody showed up. But I remember when he was hot and he was getting big crowds. And I had an event at the same time, a little different location. I had 17,000 people. He had 3,000 people. And the media reported it. And they said, Donald Trump had a rally tonight, and then he started falling asleep, right? 17,000. Then they reported on Bernie Sanders. Bernie Sanders had a massive crowd of 3,000 people tonight. 3,000 people. You know what 3,000 people is? It's like a little piece of that corner of the room. So for him, So for crazy Bernie, they had a little deal. For me, they don't want to report it. But that's okay, because we understand what's happening. Just as long as you know how dishonest these people are. And boy, were they dishonest on the debate. Man, there's never been dishonest. And by the way, it was just announced by the commission that holds the debate that Donald Trump's microphone was defective, as I've been saying. I mean, working that microphone was a hell of a lot more difficult than working crooked Hillary Clinton, that I can tell you. They just announced, it just came out a little while ago, that the microphone in the auditorium, the big room, was defective. And it was not, it was difficult. And you know, when you have a situation like that, and you know it's bad, and you think you have 100 million people watching, what do you do? Stop the show? Please fix it. It was bad. I wonder why it was bad. Think of that. I wonder why it was bad. It was so bad. Hillary Clinton has been there for 30 years and has never done anything for you or your family, and she never will. Just look how badly she messed up the Iran deal. And just today we learned that on the same day as the hostages were released, the United States signed an agreement lifting sanctions on two Iranian banks involved in financing Iran's missile program. And you know where they want those missiles to eventually land, don't you, folks? Huh? Right here. Right here. Right here, this country. That's where they want them to land. And they're taunting us with the boats. They're taunting us with the 10 sailors they captured. They're taunting us by flying right next to our airplanes. So we give them all this money, $150 billion back. We give them the deal of a lifetime. And instead of saying thank you, they feel emboldened. That won't happen with us, folks. So just think of what I said before, the way she failed upstate New York, the way she promised all those jobs that never happened. Our campaign is taking on big business. We're taking on big media, and it's not pleasant. I have never, ever in my life received stories like I receive now. I mean, it is called the greatest pile-on in the history of America. Even journalists that don't like me say it's the craziest thing they've ever seen. But I'm doing it. I'm doing it for everybody. Who knows? I'm doing it for everybody. Doing it for you. Our campaign is about breaking up the special interest monopoly in Washington, D.C. We're trying to disrupt the collusion between the wealthy donors, the large corporations, and the media executives. They're all part of the same corrupt political establishment. And they nod along when Hillary Clinton slanders you as deplorable and irredeemable. You're deplorable and irredeemable, she says. See, she doesn't know you like I know you. You are the smartest people. We're the strongest people. We're the most loyal people ever to be involved in a campaign. I call you hardworking American patriots, and together we are going to save this country. And we're not going to have a second chance, folks. If we don't do it on November 8th, it's not going to happen. I don't believe if we have to have Barack Obama, but worse, for 4 more years, I honestly believe our country can never recover. And remember, Supreme Court judges, remember that. But together we can accomplish anything we want. But that means you need to show up on November 8th. We have 39 days until the election. You have 39 days to make every dream you ever dreamed for your country come true. Do not let this opportunity slip away. Get out and vote and make sure everything is on the up and up. sure. Everything is on the up and up. You've been reading the same stories as I've been reading. So go to your place and vote and go pick some other place and go sit there with your friends and make sure it's on the up and up. Because you know what? That's a big, big problem in this country, and nobody wants to talk about it. Nobody has the guts to talk about it. So go and watch these polling places. Make sure it's on the up and up, please. That would be one hell of a way to lose, I'll tell you right now. You have one magnificent chance to deliver justice for every forgotten man, woman, and child in this nation, and there are a lot. The arrogance of Washington, D.C. will soon come face to face with the righteous verdict of the American voter. November 8th, we're going to show the whole world that America is back, bigger and better and stronger than ever before. In summing up, here are just some of the great things that will happen for your country. We're going to lower your taxes substantially. She's going to raise your taxes. We're going to eliminate every unnecessary regulation. She is going to add regulation. We're going to repeal and replace job-killing Obamacare. We're going to make child care affordable. We're bringing child care into the picture. My daughter Ivanka wants it, and I want it. We're going to bring manufacturing jobs. We're going to bring those automobile jobs back to Michigan, and I mean back fast. We're going to eliminate Common Core. We're going to bring education local. We will end illegal immigration. We will keep. We'll build the wall, and who's going to pay for the wall? 100%. Mexico's going to pay for the wall. They just don't know it yet, but trust me, they're going to pay. We have such a trade deficit with Mexico. I was in Mexico. I really like the president. I love the country. I love the people in Mexico. I have so many Mexicans, they work for me, they're friends of mine. These are great people, but their leaders are so much smarter than our leaders. We have a trade deficit that is massive with Mexico. The wall is a tiny fraction of what we're talking about. So when people say, how are they going to do it? I say, look at the trade deficit, look at the cost of the wall. And even the politicians that have no clue what's happening, they say, oh, now I get it. But they could never produce it. So we're going to have the wall, and we're going to stop drugs from pouring into our country and poisoning our youth. We're going to keep radical Islamic terrorists the hell out of our country. We are going to save the Second Amendment, which is under siege. We are going to take care of our inner cities, our African American communities, our Hispanic communities. We're going to make them good again. We're going to make them safe again. We are going to support the men and women of law enforcement. And we're going to appoint justices to the Supreme Court of the United States who will uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States. We will rebuild our roads, our bridges, our tunnels, our highways. We will rebuild so beautifully our airports, our schools, and our hospitals. American cars made right here in Michigan will travel the roads. American planes will soar the skies, and American ships will patrol the sea. American steel will send new skyscrapers into the clouds, and we will take care of our steel workers, and we will take care of our miners. We're going to take care of our miners and our steel workers. American hands will rebuild this nation, and American energy, mined from American sources, will power this nation again. American workers, many of you in this room, will be hired to do the job. And these will be great jobs. We will put new American steel into the spine of our country. I will fight for every neglected part of this nation, and I will fight to bring us all together as Americans. Imagine what our country could accomplish if we started working together as one people under one God, saluting one American flag. To the people of Michigan, I promise you this. You get out and you vote on November 8th for Donald J. Trump for president. You'll be voting for yourselves, because our movement will be complete, phase one. Phase two is we will make America wealthy and rich again. Gotta do it. We will make America strong again. We will make America safe again. And we will make America great again. Thank you. God bless you, everybody. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, man.
Thank you very much, everyone, for joining us and choosing us as your stream of choice. We hope that you guys enjoyed the rally. We stream all of the Donald Trump and Mike Pence rallies, and also we will stream all of the debates. The debate that is coming up right now in October for the vice president. So the vice presidential debate, we will stream it here live. So make sure that you guys hit that subscribe button and you join us There's a few more Donald Trump rallies coming up this week, this weekend, and this week that's coming up. So make sure that you go and set the notifications. Also, we upload news videos, breaking news videos, so make sure that you go and check them out on our main channel. Again, we thank you for choosing us as your stream of choice, and thank you to all the moderators for keeping the chat awesome and enjoyable for everyone. And we hope to see you here on the next Donald Trump rally, and also the next Mike Pence rally, and the vice presidential debate. See you guys next time. But until then, peace. And thank you very much, all of the mods. Let me give you guys a shout out real quick. All right, so we got Bill, Joe, Lena, Brian Knight, Bill, Sayuri, Roosevelt, Danny Green, Mike, Manny Garcia, Sassy D, and Jave. Thank you very much, mods. Much love. And I hope to see you guys, like I said, here next time. Don't forget, go check out the video that we uploaded earlier today and the video that we uploaded yesterday, and make sure you share it all of the social media.
We still have probably a couple thousand more people that are still lined up outside trying to get in here. So that's just awesome. It is just awesome. So thank you so much, Detroit. You are an amazing, amazing city. Thank you, Michigan. And I'm going to say this again. My role up here today is to introduce America's mayor, Mayor Giuliani, who's going to come out here. And he's awesome. He is awesome. You guys are great. You're awesome. Thank you. Okay, this election, this represents a change election. Our country will go in one direction or the other, and what we want is we want to take America back. I mean, we want America to be exactly what we know it to be. We want it to represent that flag. We want it to represent all of the American people around this country, every single one of them, including all the deplorables. I am one. I'm proud to wear that name. There are so many risks that we face. And you're going to hear all this tonight. Donald Trump will come out here, and he'll talk about, you know, illegal immigration and protecting our border and protecting our country. One of the things, and I would love to have a real shout out to all of our veterans, all veterans in the room. Woo! Hoo-ah! That's right. The men and women who serve in our armed forces, they deserve so much. And their families deserve so much. And our military, I will tell you, I'm standing up here tonight, and I'm standing alongside Donald Trump to be the next president of the United States, because when I look at our military has been depleted. We have the smallest army since World War II. We have the smallest Navy since World War I. We have the smallest Air Force we've ever had. And God love our Marine Corps. Any Marines in here tonight? Hurrah, hurrah, Marine, hurrah. Yeah, Marines say hurrah, hurrah, Marines. I hear ya. Another critical issue, very, very critical issue. The Supreme Court of the United States of America. And we must, I mean, this is such an important issue with this, and many people don't understand it. Most Americans, they think about it and you don't really understand it, but trust me, the Supreme Court of the United States of America, it basically sets our way of life. It protects the rule of law in our country. And we have to make sure that we put the right person in the White House, because the likelihood of somewhere between three, maybe five Supreme Court justices could be changed, and that is an unbelievable. Imagine Hillary Clinton putting Supreme Court. No, boo, boo. This election is about leadership. It's about honesty versus the status quo and someone who just doesn't know how to tell the truth. Hillary Clinton is so corrupt. She's just everything that comes out of her mouth, you just wonder, I mean, why does she even talk anymore? The amount of lies that she continues to say. Another group that I want to address in here tonight, and you see them here. You got the Secret Service. You look all around, and I'm sure as you drove into the parking lot tonight, is all of those men and women who serve in blue, who wear, you know, Blue Lives Matter. Our law enforcement, our cops. God love them. God love them. I mean, our police. Our police in this country are under assault. The rule of law in this country is under assault. If there's one thing that we have to protect the rule of law in this country. And the first line of defense for protecting our rule of law is the men and women who serve us on a law enforcement professionals on a daily basis. And let's give them another big round of applause. Now, one of the things that I like to do when we travel around is that we travel around together, and that's to introduce America's mayor, Rudy Giuliani. I will tell you, that's right. Now this is a guy, this is a tough guy. New York City mayor. I mean, when he was the mayor of New York, he brought crime down so much, unbelievable. And you'll hear more about that tonight. But the best city in the world, New York City under Mayor Giuliani, unbelievable guy, America's mayor. Let me introduce the next speaker, America's mayor, Mayor Rudy Giuliani.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, it's very, very nice to be here in Michigan and in a place that I know we're going to win in November. I got to tell you, you really have Hillary Clinton and the Democrats very, very nervous. They're basically pulling out of Ohio. I predict in 2 weeks we'll get them to pull out of here. You see this little group in front of me right here? No, just this little group, just in numbers. That's about what she draws at her crowd. And this is a Trump rally. You think she can beat that enthusiasm? You know why you're enthusiastic? Well, let's take the positive part first. You have a
I'm Jamie Foxx for Verizon. In the nation's largest independent study.
Give me 1 second. For some reason, I don't know what the hell happened. I'm still trying to figure out. I think it got cut from any other ones, but hold on. Let's see.
You do not understand economics. You're ignorant and you're out of your mind. And you have no understanding of economics. Here's how you create new jobs. You take a 35% tax rate, which is the highest in the world, and driving companies to places where the tax rates are lower, like Pfizer, the big plant in Ireland, where the tax rate is 12.5%, by charging them below the tax rate,
a rational one of
about 10%. And all that money comes back into the United States. And you know what it's used for? It's used for jobs and more jobs and better jobs and more opportunities. Then,
USA,
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 not only,
USA,
not only did she misrepresent about that, but when she was talking on Monday night, she said that Donald Trump wants to lower taxes the most on the rich. Wrong. Except, unlike Donald Trump, Lester Holt never interrupted her when she was wrong. He didn't say no. Simple arithmetic goes to the lowest tax rate. It's going to go down from 38% to 33%, from 33% to 25%, and from 25% to 15%. The biggest reduction will be for the middle class. Once again, Hillary was wrong. But you didn't see Lester Holt come in and say, Hillary, you're wrong. I just did the arithmetic. The other way you create jobs is you negotiate sensible tax deals. Donald Trump will renegotiate NAFTA. Do you know how many jobs you lost here in Michigan because of NAFTA? Do you know how many people are out of work or who have jobs that are below what they should be making? Thousands and thousands and thousands. Do you know who passed NAFTA? Bill Clinton. Do you know who supported it? Hillary Clinton. And once again during the debate, she didn't tell the truth. She said, well, she never really said that the TPP, which is the trade agreement with the Pacific, which hasn't been passed yet, which will be almost as bad as NAFTA and take as many jobs from us as NAFTA. She said, she never said it was the gold standard. She said it could be. 3 minutes after the debate was over, there she was on television saying, the TPP is the gold standard. Once again, she didn't tell the truth. Once again, she lied. And once again, nobody interrupted her and said, you're wrong. And every single time Donald Trump was interrupted, it turned out that Lester Holt and Hillary Clinton were wrong. They said, both of them said, that stop and frisk has been found unconstitutional. I have news for you. Stop and frisk is alive and well. It was decided by the Supreme Court in 1968, Terry versus Ohio. It is still the law of the land. It doesn't matter what Lester Holt thinks. It doesn't matter what Hillary Clinton thinks, because just like she failed economics 101, she failed her bar exam. I mean it, she did. Their ignorance of the law is only exceeded by their ignorance of foreign policy, where every single thing that she touched in this world turned out much worse. She was given a world far safer, far better, and an America that was far safer than the America of today, where we are waiting for the next attack, and we have a president who takes 3 days to react to it, and we have a president and a former Secretary of State who cannot say radical Islamic terrorism is at war against us. Well, you have a chance to elect a man who can stand up to radical Islamic terrorism, to a man who can create jobs for you to deserve, a man who can bring the ladder of success right into the heart of Detroit and pull people out of poverty the right way, with safety, a good job, and a good education. And that man is Donald Trump. And you will be hearing from him in a few moments. Make sure you vote. God bless you. God bless Michigan, and God bless the United States of America.
Wow. Wow. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. It is so great to be back in Michigan, a state I've come to know and love during this campaign. You know, we won Michigan, and that was a great, big, fat, beautiful victory. You know that, right? And I've been talking about Michigan for a long time. We can't let them take your car industry out or your industry out of your state any longer. Not gonna happen. I'm going to fight so hard for all of you, and I'm going to bring back the jobs that have been stripped away from you and from our country. In 39 days, 39 days, can you imagine? This started off, we were a long ways away, and some people didn't give us a good chance. They said, Mr. Trump, the other day, one of the biggest people in that business, the very dishonest press business, they said, Mr. Trump, when you started off, you have to tell me the truth. Did you really think you'd be here? I said, what the hell do you think I'm doing this for? Right? No, we expected to be here. And we're all here together. It's a movement. And believe me, we're all here together. We're going to take our country back. We're going to win the state of Michigan. We're going to win the White House. And it's going to be an awfully good November 8th. That evening is going to be a celebration. We're going to take on the special interests, the lobbyists and the powerful politicians that have stolen your jobs through theft and incompetence. They've stolen your wealth. They've taken your middle class. We're going to take on the arrogant, corrupt corporate media that have enabled the global theft of American prosperity. A theft that has left behind crumbling schools, roads, bridges, and a totally depleted military. We have the greatest people in the world in our military. We're going to rebuild our military. This is when we need it. It's time, by the way, to rebuild Detroit. We're going to rebuild Detroit. It's time to rebuild Michigan, and we're not letting them take your jobs out of Michigan any longer. And it's time to rebuild the United States of America. We're going to do it. Our country is going to be greater than ever before. We're going to be the smart country again. Hillary Clinton has made a living raking in donations from special interests that have raided our factories and ripped the jobs right out of Michigan and every other state. That's how she gets rich, by taking your jobs and your money away from you and away from your state. That's why Hillary Clinton, if she ever got the chance, would 100% approve the Trans-Pacific Partnership. The deal she lied about the other night, when I said she called it the gold standard, she said no. Guess what? She called it the gold standard. And Lester Holt didn't correct her. I wonder why. The Trans-Pacific Partnership will economically devastate Michigan, New Hampshire, North Carolina, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, and so many other states all across this country. It will be devastating also for Ohio. Hillary Clinton's donors want the TPP, and their wish will be her command. That's what it is. These special interests pay her for speeches, and she's not a good speaker. Not a good speaker. They pay her a lot of money. You know, we have thousands of people here today. There are thousands and thousands of people outside trying to get in. Thousands. And they're coming in. And in fact, I was going to ask you, should we hold it up for a couple of hours, let everyone pour in? You know, they're all checked. The answer is no, right? Thank you. Now they'll get in. They pay her foundation, they pay her husband, in return they get your jobs. Like I've been saying all week, when it comes to Hillary Clinton, all you have to do is remember these words. Follow the money. Let's go. That's become very popular, I will say. Hillary Clinton praised or pushed TPP on 45 separate occasions. Her close associate and confidant, Governor Terry McAuliffe, said she'd pass it, don't worry. Her husband talks it up. Everyone knows she's for it because she doesn't believe in protecting American jobs or American sovereignty. She doesn't believe it. Hillary Clinton only believes in protecting her special interests and her donors. Of the 262 companies that lobbied for the passage of TPP, 82, or nearly 1 in 3, donated between $21 and $67 million to the Clinton Foundation. Think of that. 9 companies that lobbied for the passage of TPP paid Hillary Clinton $2.7 million for paid speeches. Who would want to hear Hillary Clinton speak and pay her $200, $300, $400, $500,000? Who? You think so? You know, so we're going to have 20,000 people here, easy. Including outside, much more than that. If she came here tomorrow, if she got 500 people, seriously, I think it would be a shock, right? It would be a shock. 3 TPP member countries gave between $6 and $15 million. Think of that. At least 4 lobbies who are actively lobbying for TPP passage have raised more than $800,000 for her campaign. On November 8th, we are going to end Clinton corruption. We've had enough. And we're going to do something that has been a long, long time in coming. We are going to put America first. We are going to put America first. Hillary Clinton is an insider fighting only for herself and for her donors. I'm an outsider fighting for you. We have a movement like they've never seen in this country before. The corrupt media, which is totally corrupt, these people back there, totally corrupt, working along with the political establishment and the establishment, is panicking because they know this is awfully tough to stop what's happening right now, folks. Awfully tough. The news anchors and the donors and the lobbyists who are used to getting their way are trying to do everything they can to help crooked Hillary Clinton and to cling to their power and their prestige and their money. The arrogant political class doesn't believe in protecting jobs and wages for Americans. Do you know, we have many people in the audience and all over the country that made more money in real wages 18 and 20 years ago than they're making now. And now, because of Obamacare and other reasons, they're being forced to work two jobs, sometimes three jobs. So they're getting older, they're working harder, and they're being paid less. Not good. The only thing I can say is that I'm getting older and I'm working harder also, okay? So I'm putting myself in your category. True. Thank you.
USA, 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 USA.
Thank you.
USA,
USA. Oh, that's so true, though, isn't it? The special interests don't believe in secure borders and strong walls. The Washington and Wall Street insiders don't believe in hiring more police, producing more American energy, or giving school choice to poor children trapped in failing schools. And we are, by the way, going to end Common Core and bring education local. For decades, we've talked about the corruption and incompetence and failures of our leaders. In 2016, it's a long-awaited chance to deliver the change that you've been waiting for a long time, and to hold our politicians accountable. If you do this one simple thing, you can deliver justice for every single person who has been wronged by the system. On November 8th, show up and vote. Show up and vote, folks. Show up and vote. If you are so sick, if you get the worst report you could possibly get for the doctor, if the doctor says, I'm sorry, Jim, I'm sorry, Alice, I'm sorry, whoever it is, you're not going to make it. You're not going to make it. You'll be gone by the end of November. I don't give a damn. Show up and vote on November 8th. No, we don't want that to happen. We don't want that to happen. When you cast that ballot, just picture a Wall Street boardroom filled with the special interests who have been bleeding your country and your city and every place else, and imagine the look on their faces when you tell them you're fired. Fired. And we're going to tell millions and millions of unemployed Americans my favorite two words: you're hired. When we get it going, folks, millions of jobs are going to come pouring back into our country. We're going to reverse the trend. Right now, we have a superhighway. It goes in one direction, out of our country. Our jobs are gone. Our money's gone. Our wealth is gone. We owe $20 trillion. Obama has doubled the debt, doubled it in his term in office. $20 trillion. And we haven't done anything. Our roads are bad. Our schools are bad. Our airports are bad. Our hospitals are bad. Our bridges, our tunnels, they're all falling apart. You know, it's one thing if we would have spent the money and fixed our country We've spent $6 trillion in the Middle East. We could have rebuilt our country twice. Now the media doesn't want to talk about Hillary Clinton and her corruption. So we're going to spell it out for them today. The large corporations who support terrible trade deals that ship your jobs overseas and out of our country, they're donating to Hillary Clinton. Follow the money. The Wall Street investors who have rigged the regulations against the middle class, they're donating to Hillary Clinton. Follow the money. The wealthy donors who want to shut down American energy, they're donating to Hillary Clinton. Follow the money. The special interests who want open borders are donating to Hillary Clinton. Definitely follow the money. In her campaign for president, Hillary Clinton has received $100 million in contributions from Wall Street and hedge funds. And by the way, I'm spending a lot of money on my campaign. And why isn't she spending some money on hers? I'm spending $100 million. You know what I'm spending? I think I'll be over $100 million. But you know what's nice? When they call me and they say, Mr. President, you have to do this, you have to do that. I say, I don't have to do anything for anybody. The only one that I'm working for is you. That's the only one. You watch. So many things are done adverse to the country. And I've spent a tremendous tens and tens of millions of dollars on the primaries and now on the general election. And I'm very proud to have done it, I will tell you. And I don't know to this extent if it's ever been done before. Certainly not recently. But I'm very proud to have done it because we're going to maintain our independence. We have millions and millions of dollars coming in from small donors, average like $61 a shot. And that's really helping to fund the campaign also. But these are people who are investing in our country. These are great, great people. They're investing in our country. So Hillary and Bill were paid $150 million for speeches since Bill Clinton left the Oval Office. $150. Did they get their money's worth? Well, maybe they did, not from the speech. The same groups are paying Bill and Hillary for their speeches. These were the groups that were lobbying, in many cases, the federal government. I'm shocked. 22 groups paying Bill Clinton for speeches lobbied the State Department while Hillary was Secretary of State. Shocking. Favors and access were granted to those who wrote checks. She put the office of Secretary of State up for sale, and she never ever got the chance, and she will get the chance if we don't get out to vote. She will get the chance, and we can't let that happen. Because if she gets the chance, she will put the Oval Office up for sale like she always does. Remember, folks, she's been doing this for 30 years and she just doesn't produce. She deleted and bleached 33,000 emails after a congressional subpoena. You can't do that. After the subpoena, how about this? You get a federal subpoena. You get a subpoena from Congress. I mean, how high can it get? To give your emails, to give your papers, to give everything. It isn't before you get the subpoena. This is after you get the subpoena. And after you get the subpoena, you delete and bleach, a process nobody ever heard of. Who heard of that in this room? Did anybody ever hear of it? They call it bleaching, they call it acid washing. And a lot of people don't do it because it's supposed to be very expensive. But nobody heard of it. So she gets a subpoena. She doesn't like it. She says, in my opinion, or somebody does, but she says, delete all of my emails. Delete them. And then she said, and by the way, is there another process where they can never find them? Yes, ma'am, we can bleach them. Then bleach them. Because I don't want anybody to see the wedding and the yoga classes, right? She said they were wedding and yoga class tweets. I give five for the wedding and three for the yoga class, but what about the rest? In addition, she got rid of 13 phones. They were missing or gone, and several were destroyed by a hammer. Who ever destroyed your phone with a hammer? Is there anybody? There's one person. What business are you in? Foreign enemies with easy access to hack. And believe me, she's vulnerable. And she makes us vulnerable because foreign enemies, you look at her server, and they're probably hacking her all over the place. Unfortunately, maybe we'll find out at a later date. Lies to Congress under oath. She lies to Congress. How many times did she lie to Congress? And then the media protects her, and they don't talk about that. And if I'm a little bit off, Trump lies. She lied to Congress so many times. And how about her people and representatives taking the Fifth Amendment and her ringleaders getting immunity deals, five immunity deals. We call them now the FBI Immunity Five. So, Listen to this. Here's my question for Hillary Clinton. Can you promise that not one of the five people who were granted criminal immunity will ever be allowed to serve in a Clinton administration if that ever happens? Oh, would that be bad? Let's see what happens. And here's a demand I'm making today to President Obama. Mr. President, will you pledge not to issue a pardon to Hillary Clinton and her co-conspirators for their many crimes against our country and against society itself? Will you make that pledge? No one is above the law. Clinton and her cronies will say anything, do anything, lie about anything to keep their grip on power, to keep their control over our country. Remember the Clinton pardon? A fugitive, and this was a serious fugitive, Mark Rich, in exchange for unknown and undisclosed amounts of money. You remember that? Mark Rich. Famous Mark Rich. People couldn't believe it. The American people have had it with years or decades of Clinton corruption and scandals. Always the same thing. Whitewater, the cattle. Remember the cattle? I think she had the greatest return on a cattle investment in the history of the cattle world. Guys that did it all their lives, they said, wow, she must know a lot about cattle. The people of this country are tired of the lies. They're tired of trivial politics. They're tired of being talked down to, looked down upon, and treated like second-class citizens. This will finally be the year that the American people say, enough is enough. Hillary Clinton has been a disaster for so many communities, but especially for the African American communities. I don't think African Americans are going to come out and vote for Clinton. They're too smart, and they know they are being used. They're tired of it. They also know from tremendous past experience that she'll do nothing for them once the election is over. She never does, and that will never change. Many of them will not forget her calling young African-American men super predators. Super predators. To the African-American community, let me ask you this question. Are you better off than you were 8 years ago? No. If not, why not give Donald Trump a chance? I will fix it. I will bring back jobs. I'll bring back your education, which is a total disaster in the inner cities. And I'm going to bring back safe neighborhoods. If you keep voting for the same people, you will keep getting the exact same results. Look at what the Democrats have done to Detroit. Half of Detroit residents are unable to work. Nearly 40% of the city lives in poverty. It's the second most dangerous city in America, according to the FBI. This is the legacy of the policies embraced by crooked Hillary Clinton. A Trump administration will bring prosperity to all of our people. My economic agenda can be summed up with three very beautiful words. Jobs, jobs, jobs. We're bringing our jobs back. We're going to pass the biggest tax cut since Ronald Reagan. And by the way, Hillary Clinton is going to raise your taxes. Every wasteful and unnecessary regulation will be immediately eliminated. They're choking our businesses and stopping our jobs. We will unleash the power of American energy. The catastrophe known as Obamacare will be repealed and replaced. And the disastrous trade deals like NAFTA, signed by Bill Clinton, that have caused so much pain in Michigan and Ohio and Pennsylvania and everywhere in this country, will be renegotiated and will bring back your auto manufacturing business like you've never, ever seen it before. Michigan has lost more than one in three of its manufacturing jobs since the twin disasters of NAFTA and China's entrance into the WTO, another Bill Clinton disaster. Before NAFTA went into effect, there were 280,000 auto workers in Michigan. Today, that number is only 160,000, and believe me, it's going down. and going down fast. And after the election, if somebody else should win, you're going to see really big reductions in those numbers. I can promise you that, because that's what they're going to do. And I've been talking about Michigan. I was honored here years ago, and we set the all-time record. Years ago, long before I ever thought I was going to be doing this, whoever thought I was going to run for office, I was going to be a politician. Can't believe somebody said, Donald, you're a politician. I say, please, I don't want to hear that. But whoever thought. But long before I thought about doing this, I was honored in Michigan. And I talked about your car industry is moving out. And had I run for office then and won, you would have double and triple the number of workers in your car industry, your automobile industry. I guarantee you that. But we'll get them back anyway. Ford just announced that it's moving its small car production to Mexico. So, it used to be that the cars were made in Flint, and you couldn't drink the water in Mexico. Today, the cars are made in Mexico, and you can't drink the water in Flint. That's what's happened to our country. Hillary Clinton also gave us the job-killing trade deal with South Korea, which has been a disaster. It's cost our country another 100,000 jobs. And Hillary opposed the Korea deal when she was running for president in 2007. She campaigned right here in Michigan and said, the Korea deal will hurt the United States auto industry, increase our trade deficit, cost us good middle-class jobs, and make America less competitive. She pledged to you to reject the deal, but she lied, as always. She lied. Once installed as Secretary of State, she supported it and called it a cutting-edge transaction. Same thing's going to happen with TPP. Don't give her the chance, folks. You're going to lose all your jobs. Don't forget, when she ran for the Senate in New York State, she said she was going to bring back jobs in upstate New York. It was a total lie. We lost more and more jobs, and today it's a total disaster. She rammed it through, as she always tries to do. Her donors were happy. They were all extremely friendly to her. They helped her out. Everybody was satisfied, except for the workers of our country. We lost our jobs. The U.S. trade deficit with Korea for the top 10 products that Michigan exports to Korea grew 54% as exports fell and imports rose. So it was an exact opposite of what she said. And she probably knew it, although I personally think she's incompetent. She might not have known it. Don't forget, she has a distinction. She failed her bar exam in Washington, D.C. Remember that. That's a big distinction. This is what Hillary Clinton did for your state. According to the Economic Policy Institute, Michigan ranks first for jobs lost as a share of workforce due to the trade deficit with TPP members. Okay? Just imagine how many more jobs will be lost if the TPP actually gets approved, as Hillary Clinton wants to make sure it happens. Hillary Clinton is merely a vessel for the special interests trying to strip this country of its wealth, its jobs, and its status as a sovereign nation. She even supports the disastrous surrender of America's control of the internet, which is happening now. How about Obama? How about Obama wants to give the internet, let it be given to the world? What a bunch of people we have representing us. What a bunch of people. See how nice I'm doing, you know? A year ago, I would have said something vicious, and they would have said, Donald Trump uses foul language. What a group we have. How about where Obama, on the worst deal that I've ever seen negotiated, the Iran deal, started by Hillary Clinton, by the way, which will give them nuclear weapons in less than 10 years. And it's an easy path. But how about where he gave them $400 million in cash? And then it turned out to be wrong. It was $1.7 billion in cash. Can you believe it? You know what that is? It's take that corner of the room and stack the cash to the ceiling. Nobody's seen that. Has anybody ever seen $1.7 billion in cash? What a bunch of losers we have. Hillary Clinton's website says she supports the decision to give away the internet to a global community of stakeholders. Isn't that nice? We come up with the internet and they want to give it away. Isn't that wonderful? Someone needs to inform Hillary Clinton it's not the job of our leaders to represent the global community. It's the job of our leaders to represent American citizens. We invent the internet. Let's just give it away, folks. Let's just give it away. Hard, it really is, honestly. Is it hard to believe or what? Forget about running for office. Forget about voting. Forget about politics. Can you believe the things they do? 400 million? Turns out to be 1.7. In cash, the internet. How about last week where they were going to deport 800 people? Now, they have a reason they were going to deport them, right? So they were going to deport 800 people. And guess what? Something went wrong. And instead of deporting them, they became citizens of the United States of America. Only in America. Don King, who supported me, Big Don, he goes, only in America can that happen. But they were wrong. But there was a mistake. There was a mistake. It turned out that the 800 person number was wrong. It looks like it's now going to be close to 1,800. And then I said, okay, they made a big mistake. Let's turn it around and let's deport them. And they said, but that wouldn't be constitutional. Can you believe these people? Can you believe these people? America losing control of the internet to foreign entities is just one more way Obama Clinton have sold out the citizens of this country. Somebody's benefiting by that deal, because nobody can be so stupid to make a deal like that. Somebody is benefiting by that deal. Hillary Clinton is a globalist who will never protect the freedom and jobs of the American people. I'm not running to be president of the world. I'm running to be president of the United States of America. Have you ever wondered why it is that all things that the American people want never, ever seem to happen? The reason's simple. It's because the financial interests who control our politics and our media, which is one of the most dishonest groups of people ever in this country. Like, for instance, look at this massive crowd. They don't show the crowd, folks. I go home, my wife said, oh, were there many people? I say, thousands. She goes, really? I didn't see them. They don't show them. Hey, cameras, why don't you span the room and show the room, cameras. Span the room. They won't do it. They won't do it. They never do it. They never do it. They're dishonest people. Dishonest people. I remember during the primaries, when Bernie Sanders was doing well, he made a terrible deal. He sold out to the devil, you know that. And now people don't even want to show up for Bernie. He sold out. He should have never made that deal. He should have gone down. He would have been an American hero. He sold out to Hillary Clinton. He sold out to the devil, and his people don't want anything to do with him. He had an event the other day. Almost nobody showed up. But I remember when he was hot and he was getting big crowds. And I had an event at the same time, a little different location. I had 17,000 people. He had 3,000 people. And the media reported it. And they said, Donald Trump had a rally tonight. And then he started falling asleep, right? 17,000. Then they reported on Bernie Sanders.